Welcome, science investigators. Today, we're diving into one of the most important topics you'll ever learn. Nope, not rocket science. Lab safety. It's not just about looking cool in goggles, although that's a nice perk. It's about staying safe while you explore the amazing world of science. Mia, were you watching the... See, scientists? This is why lab safety is so important. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain why lab safety is important, identify key lab safety equipment and its purpose, and carefully follow lab safety guidelines and instructions. Let's jump in. The best ways to learn about science is to do science. With your parents' or guardians' permission, you'll have the opportunity to complete home lab investigations throughout this course. Believe it or not, science happens everywhere, including in our homes and with everyday materials. But in order to make the most of these investigations, we first have to understand lab safety. Why do you think lab safety is important? Pause the video here and record your thoughts. Lab safety is like learning the rules of a sport before you play the game. Imagine stepping onto a basketball court or soccer field without knowing the rules. People could get hurt, and the game would be total chaos. In a lab investigation or science experiment, lab safety rules are your playbook to make sure everyone stays safe and the game goes smoothly. So, what's in this science safety playbook? You can remember the purpose of lab safety by remembering the four P's: prepare, protect, prevent, and plan. Having a clear understanding of lab safety will help you to prepare your materials and your workspace, protect your body by choosing the right protective equipment for your lab investigation, prevent any issues from happening by building safe science habits, and finally, have an emergency plan to handle accidents, spills, and other unexpected issues. The first P is prepare. Think of this like warming up before a big game. Properly preparing will set you up for success. Start by printing out your lab lesson activities and grabbing a writing utensil. Science can happen quickly, so you'll need to be able to record observations as they happen. Next, read over the lab activity thoroughly with a parent or guardian. This is like your game plan for a scientific investigation. Pay special attention to the safety icons to learn about any special recommendations for the activity. Read through the materials list and lab procedure and check that you have everything. Halfway through a lab is not the time to realize you're missing an ingredient. Once you've reviewed everything, your parent or guardian can decide if you have the materials, space, and safety equipment needed to proceed. Never do a lab without parent or guardian permission and without reading the instructions and safety guidelines first. With adult approval, it's time to pick a good workspace. Some labs involve water or heat, so pick a flat surface near a sink or stove if possible. A kitchen is often a great choice. Before setting up, check your surroundings. Is there good airflow? Will you have enough space for all the materials? If you take time choosing the right lab spot now, you'll be able to focus on the science during the lab. Finally, clear and organize your workspace. Remove any food or drinks and clear the clutter from your surface. Phones can be distracting, so if you have one, place it off to the side. Set out all of your lab materials so they're within reach and in order of use. Some lab steps happen fast, so having everything ready to go will keep things running smoothly. The second P is protect. This is where you gear up. Just like you'd wear pads or a helmet during a football game, protective equipment in a lab keeps you safe from spills, splashes, and other surprises. Can you think of any examples of lab safety gear? Start with your eyes. Goggles are a must to protect them from any chemicals or flying bits. In any science lab investigation, goggles should be the very first piece of gear you put on and the very last thing you take off after you've finished the lab and cleanup. Closed-toed shoes protect your feet from any broken glass or spills, and gloves help shield your hands from irritating chemical substances. You won't need gloves for every lab, but always check the safety icons to know for sure. And don't forget your clothes. Trust me, a lab coat isn't just for looking spiffy. It can save your favorite shirt from messy spills. If you don't have a lab coat, an apron or an old t-shirt should do the trick. Finally, make sure to tie back long hair, roll up loose sleeves, and remove any dangly jewelry. You don't want anything getting caught in your lab setup. Now for the third and most important P, prevent. Prevention is all about building safe science habits so that accidents don't happen in the first place. It's like following the rules of a game to keep it safe and fun. So, what exactly are these safe habits? First, follow all instructions exactly. If a lab calls for a tablespoon of baking soda, don't eyeball it, don't add extra. Measure it. Not only could you mess up your results, but doing things differently from the instructions can be unsafe. Another rule for preventing any mishaps? Never engage in horseplay of any kind during a lab activity. This isn't the time to fly paper airplanes or see how long you can hop on one leg. Remember, you want to prevent accidents from happening. Speaking of preventing accidents, keep pets away from your lab investigation, no matter how cute they are. Scientists also prevent danger in the lab by never eating or drinking during a lab, especially when chemicals are being used. Even if your home lab is actually the kitchen, make sure all food is put away during your lab investigations and that you clean the area thoroughly and wash your hands before eating or drinking after a lab. Sometimes you may use food or candy in your science investigations. Even if a material is technically edible, don't put anything in your mouth unless expressly instructed to do so. We know that observations can be made with all five senses, but it's a good idea to be careful about how we use those five senses. Unless told otherwise, you won't be tasting in the lab. Finally, to prevent any emergencies, be extremely careful around heat, glass, and sharp objects. Never leave a flame or boiling pot of water unattended, and never look directly into glassware that's being heated. Yes! Even if you're wearing goggles. Building these safety habits will help set you up for success as you complete lab investigations. But what happens when you do everything right and an accident happens? This is where the final P comes in, your emergency plan. Even when you prepare, protect, and prevent, accidents can still happen. So having a plan for emergencies is crucial. It's like knowing what to do if you fall during a soccer match. You've got to be ready to respond. First, never complete a lab without a parent or guardian at home. You want to make sure you have backup in case of an emergency during the lab. And speaking of emergencies, always have a first aid kit nearby as well. This could include bandages for small cuts or burns, and even water in case something splashes onto you. If something happens to get in your eye, don't rub it in. Turn on a sink and gently rinse your eye underneath the water for 5 minutes. Keep water and an old towel close at hand for any spills. Make sure you or an adult nearby knows how to use a fire extinguisher or fire blanket just in case of a fire. Finally, have a phone nearby in case you need to call for help. You don't want to waste time trying to find a phone if an emergency happens. Accidents and mistakes can happen to even the most careful scientists, but with a detailed emergency plan, you'll have the confidence to stay calm and safe, even in an emergency. Remember, lab safety isn't just something to think about. It's something you practice every single time you do science. Follow the four P's and you'll be well on your way to safe and successful experiments. Now go, be awesome, be curious, and most importantly, be safe. I'm Caroline, and remember, life is full of wonders, so keep learning and don't ever stop wondering. Hey!